Time now to bring in Scott Hartnell, the Philadelphia Flyers. Scott, great to have you with us, and I got to get right to it. I saw This Is 40. You were tremendous, but I want to know, tell us about Leslie Mann.
What a gorgeous woman, and a sweetheart, too. She was absolutely incredible, made us feel super comfortable, and, you know, hopefully that's my end to Hollywood now.
Hey, how does that come about? How did that whole thing happen, Scott? I mean, you're just not walking down the street one day and all of a sudden they bring in and you do a movie. How do you get involved with something like that?
Well, I think the whole premise behind the whole scene was to have, you know, a guy with no teeth and exchanging with Megan Fox. That was kind of, I think, in the script or whatever it's called. And they asked Ian to do it with Barriere, and, you know, I kind of heard about it, and I was like, well, you know, it'd be kind of cool if I could do it. And you needed to be American, obviously, or have a green card. I have my green card, and it was pretty cool. I'm glad I did it to be a part of it, and, you know, I have a lot more respect for those actors and the hours and stuff that they put into. We were there from 7 a.m. to 11 o'clock at night, 16 hours, and it was just an incredible experience.
How many takes for your scene, Scott? Be honest. You get one take?
No, well, the cameras were, like, behind the girls facing us, like, shooting us first, and, you know, we went around the circle, everyone was asking questions, kind of, you know, just kind of talking like you normally would, and, you know, then that was probably 45 minutes cut. We got to take all the cameras around, which probably took about an hour to set up, look at the girls' faces, and then we did the whole conversation again, and, you know, then there was the dancing part that took another few hours to set up and to do. So it was quite the process, and, you know, the hours that they put in for a 2-hour movie is just probably astronomical.
And what happened to Ian LaPerriere? Did he get aced out of this whole thing?
Did he get what?
Did he get aced out of this whole thing? I mean, did he get enough camera time?
Oh, he was in there. He exchanged saliva with her. So that was cool.
Scott, you know why you were cast? It was because of the hair. Be honest about it.
It was short. We shot this thing 2 summers ago, not this past one, but the one before. So it took, you know, over a year and a half to put all that stuff together. So
it's amazing. Amazing. Yeah.
Well, Scott, I got to ask you. I mean, you say it's the long hours, right, of doing a movie. It's kind of like your old linemate, Jaromir Jagr, showing up at the rink at 12 o'clock midnight trying to skate and do things. I mean, you guys put in long hours, too.
We have, actually. It's, you know, it's everything. Everybody's super excited to be here at training camp. Everyone's, you know, there early, working out hard, extra, you know, staying on the ice afterwards, you know, getting a bike ride in upstairs. And, you know, it's almost like the flu. It's contagious. Everyone's, you know, fired up for Saturday start. And, you know, it's going to be a busy schedule every second day for basically 3-4 months straight. So it's going to be quite the season. It's going to make good for, you know, the playoff races and everything in between.
Scott, you guys open up against Pittsburgh. A lot of questions about your defense. Chris Pronger is out. A lot of other guys are banged up. And Ilya Bryzgalov obviously needs to improve. How concerned are you about your team's ability to stop the other guys?
I have a lot of confidence, actually. I looking around the room the last couple of days, and Curtis Foster, we just signed, 6'5", can move pretty well. He's got a big shot. Grossman, we signed last year. Coburn, Luke Shen, the trade with JVR. You know, the smallest guy is Kimo Tiemann, and he's probably our best defenseman. So we've got a big group of D-men out there. Hopefully they can be physical, stay healthy, and, you know, hopefully scare the other players, best players, to stay away from our net and make it hard on them. So I like where we went this offseason.
Hey, Scott, you had such great chemistry last year with Claude Giroux and Jaromir Jagr. You had a great year yourself. You end up making the All-Star team. Jagr's gone now. Who is going to fill in on that side? Of all these guys that you have a bunch of really talented forwards. Is it going to be someone like a Braden Schenn? Or who is it going to be that can maybe fill in and fit in with you two guys?
Well, I think, like you said, you could put probably, you know, 2 or 3 different guys there and try them out. But, you know, it's pretty simple, the line combination, what we try and do, get the puck to Claude and go to the net. that's what I do anyway. And, you know, Jagr is a great playmaker, and, you know, we're going to miss that veteran presence. But, you know, Braden's been playing. He's been had a heck of a season thus far with that Rondek Phantoms in the AHL. So, you know, he's been playing a lot, and hopefully he can, you know, add a lot of you know, physical presence, a lot of skill. He's got, you know, great hands, good shots. So I think it's going to be a good fit.
Scott, last 4 years, fewest games you've played in any of those 4 years is 80. Pretty reliable. How have you managed to stay so healthy?
Well, that 80 season, I got suspended 2 games, too, so it wasn't because of injury. But I don't know. It's just, I guess, you know, keeping your body, I guess, well nutrition, I don't know. Just, try not to get hurt, really. You know, and the way that I play, I'm pretty physical. You know, I like to mix it up every now and again. And, you just have to, obviously don't put yourself in some bad situations where you might get hit. And, I had a few concussions early in my career. And, if I didn't smarten up and kind of change the way I played a little bit, I'd be afraid I would be playing right now because of head injuries. And I think that I've learned a lot since I was 18, 19, that's for sure.
Your owner, Ed Snyder, came out and gave a vote of confidence to the goaltender, Ilya Bryzgalov, very strong vote of confidence. And, you're someone who came from Nashville. You made the adjustment to playing in Philadelphia. Philadelphia can be a tricky place to play. It can be great. It can be troubling if things aren't going so well. Do you think year two will be a little bit more of a stable year for Ilya Bryzgalov in goal?
I think he had a lot of things going on last year. His personality is, a little bit different. I think goalies are different in general, but he's, probably the cream of the crop there. And, with the media, how they took him, I don't think they really knew how to portray him, if he was joking or not when he was talking. And, I think he, settled into a new house, and, I don't think he got into that until a couple months into the season. So, there's a lot of outside factors that people don't really realize. I know I struggled when I came to Philadelphia with the new big contract, and it took me a while to get going. So, I do have a lot of confidence in Briz, and he does in practice he can let in a soft one or whatever, but it's when you actually get him to get pumped up and try and have that competitive edge, he's he can score on him. So I think he's going to be great, and especially in this shortened season, he's played a little bit over in the KHL, and we're looking forward to it.
All right, Scott, good luck. Thanks so much for your insight. Love Leslie Mann. Loved you in This Is 40, and good luck to you and the Flyers this year.
Thanks, guys. Hopefully talk to you soon.
All right. See you at the Oscars.